USA won't see where these girls have just bypassed.
All right, here we go. It looks like you're going to have another chance at number two. And converted.
Yes, that's true.
When you are the best at anything in the world, you can say life is good. And we can say that for Susan Atino, who is a world champion, after helping the Mighty Cranes win the World University Netball Championship last week in a thrilling final against South Africa. That was nervy, that was exhilarating, that was exciting. She's going to tell us all that and so much more here on this edition of Off the Pitch. Susan, good to have you on Off the Pitch. I know you have so much to tell us, but first of all, you're welcome to Off the Pitch.
Thank you very much, and I'm glad and humbled to be here.
Personal question, do you prefer Susan or Atino, or both?
Both, because I love my names.
Susan Atino. All right. Welcome back from the final. Welcome back from the World University Championship.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
How was the experience? Just when you think about it, do you still feel goosebumps? Do you still get goosebumps thinking about it?
Yeah, a little bit, but not as such, because we did get up a win from them. But when you think about it, of course, you'd be like, I think we need them much more, to hit them more.
you're hoping to find them somewhere down the road. Are you used to the fact that you're a world champion, or you're still getting used to it? Do you wake up in the night and pinch yourself and just to make sure it is really you?
Of course, to be a world champion, you have to get from nowhere to somewhere. But now I'm used to being a champion. Yeah.
We will talk a little bit more about the championship and that final against South Africa in particular. But how has the reaction been from friends, family? You know, those games were televised. Obviously, all of Uganda's games were televised on Urban TV. What was the reaction from friends and family? Did it make it easier for you? Did it increase the pressure on you? Hey, Susan, we saw you on TV. You had a great game. You had a terrible game. What was it like?
I think being the hosts, you know, we had family members, friends, almost the whole country was looking at us because it's a world championship tournament. So it was, I can't say it was really like a walkover, but it was pressure. You know, you had to give in your best so that, you know, you please the whole world because everyone is looking at you. You make your family happy. And friends all, because they were here to support.
Yeah. Netball, and in particular Ugandan netball, is one of the most successful things. It's one thing that we do well, you know, one of the few things we do well. What is the secret? What is it with you netball girls? How come you figured this thing out? What have you done? What's the secret?
The secret is not that big, because it's a secret, but not almost a secret, because, you know, we go hand in hand with teamwork. You know, it doesn't have to be personal. The support from the government, the support from your family, of course. So it's really like teamwork as a country, as a team. Yeah, so that's the way to go, the secret about it, and going strong, knowing that, you know, you have to give in all your best, no matter how you perform. But you always have to give in your best. Yeah.
And we were chatting just offset. And generally, you told me for you it was a normal thing. You know, it was just netball games, regular netball games. But when you sit back and think that this is a world championship, and that you're actually playing for the best in this category, do you look back and say, this is something special for me as a player? Do you get those moments where you're thankful for being able to achieve that at such a young age?
Yeah, of course. You look at the things of, you know, achievement. It's not really easy. You have to go strong. And, you know, before that whole session of the tournament, of course, you work hard for it. You go training so hard. You be like, you know, we have to do our best, no matter which country crosses over. So you have to hit it up. But most of all is, you know, we dedicated the whole championship to God first. You know, you can't do anything without God. So above all, it was God. Then going hard as a team, having the perfect coaches, perfect guidance from even the netball, you know, fraternity. So it was really good going.
Yeah. I passed by here when you guys were training for the championship, and you're training here. And at that time, we didn't know where the championship was going to be held. And at that point, it seemed as though the championship would be brought here. And all along, we had known it would be played at Makere. And then finally, you know, the facilities opened. Incomplete though it were, but it was a facility, a new facility, the best netball floor in the country, the biggest seat, are much bigger than this one. And it is you guys who are effectively opening this thing. Did that add to the pressure? You had to win this. I mean, after everything the government had been invested, of course, almost 15 billion spent on the facility, hurriedly constructed. Did it make it feel like if we don't win this championship, we've let the country down? Was that the feeling you had as a team? And if so, did that make it, how did that push you or restrict you?
Having not known where the championships were going to be, you know, it was really hard, but we had good guidance from the committee of the whole championship, because no matter where the games were going to be, we were determined and going strong to win. Basically that, because we didn't really put in, you know, thoughts of letting down the country, because we knew we were good. And we are champions, of course. It's not the first championship that we won. You look at our elder, you know, sisters of the Shikranes, you know, they put up their best, so they come and encourage you during the training. So we really had to not to let down the country, yeah.
How did you feel playing in a facility like that on home soil? You know, given the past training at Nambole, Nachivubo, on hard surfaces when it rains, training is out. How did you feel playing in a facility like that here?
It was amazing, yeah. Very much amazing. I think it's one of the best facilities around for netball, and I give credit to that, and you know.
And what does it say about the sport of netball and how the country is beginning to appreciate that this is a big deal? Does it make you feel like you're getting the recognition that you deserve as a sport?
I think it's being recognized, you know, it's because of the hard work you put in, you know, with time, you know. Hard work pains, but you know, it pays to an extent, and I believe there is time for everything, and this is the time to shine, of course.
Time to shine from a world champion here on off the pitch, Susan Amito, the center for Uganda, the mighty Cranes, who beat South Africa last Friday to win the World University Netball Championships. You play a very sensitive position. So much goes through you as a player. You have to be extremely agile. You have to be composed. You also have to make quick decisions. And you have to be accurate because you're passing the ball too much. Do you love that, or do you sometimes get overwhelmed by all of that?
Being as a midfielder, I love my position because, you know, you're the brains behind the whole on the whole pitch. So it's really challenging, though you really have to know who you are at the position that you really play. You know, you have to make quick decisions. You know what to do at the right time. And it's not an easy thing, but, you know, it's a talent.
Yeah.
Liz, and netball is actually a very physical sport. When you get the ball, yes, there's that rule of space that your opponent has to give you, the 3-centimeter rule. But before that, there's fighting for space before you get the ball, and you don't look like you're the strongest like you're the strongest human being, but you told us that you have the muscles, they are hidden inside. How is it? How do you love the physical challenge of it all, or you'd rather just pass the ball and not get into the? Does it get you going, the physicality of netball, the physicality of the sport?
Okay, it's not really about the physicality, though partially, you know, it contributes to a good performance. But, you know, behind it, you have to have the brains.
Sure.
You know, what am I supposed to do at this time? If someone is physically challenging me in this kind of position, what am I going to do about it? You know, you have to go soft about it and, you know, do your thing.
Yeah.
Yes, so you get to do what you get to do.
So you're not getting muscles anytime soon, the way you're talking.
Not really, that inside. That inside.
Inside. Interesting. You're supposed to be on the netball team that played at the World Cup some time ago. Of course, that smile says it all, because the decision was taken very late to cut you off the team, and it was very painful for you, right? Do you remember that time, and bouncing back from that to this, how do you feel about that?
I think it was a learning situation, you know, having been there. You know, we were 15 of us that went into camp for the World Cup preparations, but I was among the three that were chopped off. Since I was the last, I was the youngest player on the team, it was a grateful moment, you know, though I felt bad, you know, of course you feel bad, but I was so grateful because I learned a lot of things as an individual, as a team, you know, it's a social community that we deal in. It was really challenging, but I learned a lot, and I didn't have any problem with that.
You didn't feel like quitting the sport and concentrating on something else?
Not really, because it's a talent. However much you quit, you know, you got it in blood, so there's no way you can quit.
Oh yeah, I meant to ask you as well, lest I forget. You play a very active position, but I also noticed that you're wearing glasses, and you have to be accurate. You have to be very active, but you seem to have an impediment. But you're watching off the pitch with Susan Atino, center of the Mighty Cranes, and definitely one for the future of the netball She Cranes. Keep it here.
Wow, time is the end of the game. It's the end of the fourth quarter, and it's Team Uganda. You can see all the supporters up and down. You see, wow. Listen to the chant.